dressing tables on the Jihad. Yeah, it's been popular today. No big threat that they are intending to do terror attack. The extremists against any agreement with Israel, the Hamas, so they are the real enemies. And definitely they are pushed by Iran. So in fact, this is what Professor Arabic, University of New York, and known to be, previously the chairman, international chairman of the Pale, was really at the time quite famous. This is pattern recognition, image processing, or research, all of these are based on it. So we had a site together called TorahCourse.us. One can see there are a lot of tables that we did, the professor did. So one of them that we did, really, is what Professor Aralik found, and he looked really for Jihad, and the connection, you know, which is with Iran, they are pushing the Jihad, they give you the surprise of the paper and everything. So Iran, Jihad, Ashur, Syria, Pleshet, Philistine, Pishtim, and Egypt, all those came, as you can see here, we have the Jihad, coming here Jihad, and then Iran, Syria, and the Philistines, definitely. And somehow Egypt also comes here. In fact, if you look into the other nations who in the past were enemies of Israel, Canaanites and so on. Now, finding the statistic of it, Professor Aralik found that it is 2,500, maybe not so much, but still something, you know, it is considered significant. So this is what he found, as you can see, all this interesting, also connected to Magog, because Magog is a group of nations, and all of this come together here. Now let us see what I found. I mean, definitely also the same names, Jihad and so on, Philistines, and really done with the program of Dr. Rottenberg. This is his program. He did it very, very useful. He himself became religious, Orthodox Jew, when he saw the phenomena of the cross, which is a clean pull the Torah from heaven. The five books of Moses were the blueprint of creation, therefore is everything there. Now he says that things which are found in one book are definitely much more significant. And interesting that all what you see here, now just you're going to see, appears in one book, Deuteronomy. You see AAA in Deuteronomy, a few chapters, and this is a book that contains Vilna Gaon, really has in it most of the events of the sixth millennium, where we are now. It's very interesting. So what you have here the word Hajiyad, the Jihad, the more letters more, Hajiyad, and definitely connecting with what the Ares we said, to do with the Islam, which come in Islamic, even Islamic, yeah, Islamic. And then terror, yeah, terror is part of their work, their profession, definitely. And then you have the Iran, this is what those who are pushing them, Iranian, yeah. Then Hamas you have here, Hamas, you see Hamas. In Gaza, we said many times that Gaza is a source of evil. And as we mentioned many times, the Kabbalah said if you write the letter Ein Zayin fully, Zayin A, you have the inner letter which are Yud Nun 60, Zayin Yan 70, and 1. And the Satyan, which is the macro body of the evil angel of the Amalekite, which is Samael. You see, Samael comes here parallel, and parallel is significant. You know, one letter here, that's significant, but when you find parallel, it means it has something. Now, the most interesting is that you have exactly the word about Amalek, when the Torah says, a few weeks ago, do you remember, Zachor et asher asalach Amalek, remember what the Amalekite did to you, Baderch on the way, when you came out from Egypt, אשר ככה בדרך, he met you on the way, even explanation, אשר ככה, ככה כמוצא from cool, he made you cool in the faith, believe in God, ואיזה לבך, נכשלים אחריך, he tried to catch all those, he went backwards. So amazing, the Amalekite, which are exactly as those nations, Jihad and Iran, because this was our Sejah Selah, Amalek is an Amlak, a nation who want to lick Jewish blood like a dog. It means this is people who want to wipe out the Jewish people. Exactly this is what Iran wants, and Hamas and Jihad, extremists, definitely, as we see today. So amazingly, they come. But also, you have to remember that our Rabbi Stevens, why Amalek came to attack, because the Jews desecrate the Shabbos. The story before, the Jews desecrate the Shabbos, and immediately, Vayavah Amalek, Amalek came to fight with them. The same thing our Rabbi Stevens, that the Amalek came on the place of Fidim. It is important to know the place, because Fidim means Raf Yadayim. The hands were loose in keeping Torah mitzvot, yeah. It's amazing. This was also the place of Fidim that the Israel gave to the Egyptian Sinai. So, interesting, exactly the right thing. This are Jihad, who want to wipe out Israel, the Islamic, you know, and the Samael, the angel of the Amalek. Amalek is the Samael is, and our Rebbe said, Samael means Samakel, you want to blind God, which means that he doesn't want God to control this world, you know. So amazingly, also you have Iran here, you see Iran comes together, because this is also what is interesting, that you have the female, you know, in Kabbalah, very famous, there is a masculine, which is a Samael, what you have here, and then you have the female, which is a Lilith, which come here, yeah. Now she is the heavenly angel of the Arabs, of lust, in charge of lust, Samael is more on pride, hatred. So amazing, the both of them comes here, yeah, he comes parallel, and this one also comes in an amazing way. So we have Islamic, we said, Islamic, which the Jihad is, Samael here, Hamas, and Gaza, this is the place of the Samael, the source of evil, as we saw another. Also you have Ismail, yeah, this is also Islam, Ismail, because they're connected to Ismail. So all together, very interesting, and perhaps the most interesting, is that here is a location, the Torah is, when God said, if Jews will translate the Torah, so he will make them cross with no nation, yeah? Villain nation. Amazing, this is what it is in Lachneem, below Am, it means people which are not a nation, exactly what the Philistines are. These are not a nation, yeah? What was before the Philistines, all the Philistines today. So lo am, you are suffering all from them, Hamas and Jihad, all of these. You don't a place, a nation. And Goyen Aval, villain nation, very villain, you know. This is the kind of terrorists that we have. Amazing, this is what the Torah says, but this is written the Torah says. If you use to transgress the Torah, then this is what they will have. This is what they have today. Hamas and Jihad, all those exactly. The description of the Torah, see how the Torah is true, and everything is terror, by the way, of the word terror. So all together, very significant, and unfortunately, you know that, you know what is going on in Israel now, they are very worried that the Jihad will do some kind of terror attack, serious one, because they want to disturb and to do everything, that this agreement with Hamas in Israel will take place, and this is what Iran wants, because they want wipe out Israel, they don't want agreement. Which keep Israel. Amazing, this is the situation, and this is the Torah, what the Torah tells us. So what is the solution? That we'll keep the Torah, we keep the Shabbos, the purifying, but unfortunately in Israel, when those, the heads of the party, of the blue, white, yes, says they will not transport on Shabbos, civil wedding and so on, so against the Torah, and especially Lapid, with anti-religious, anti-Orthodox of the time knows. Yeah, so definitely this kind of leaders, yeah, a little bit difficult to have peace and quiet. So important, significant tables, let us really hope that before Passover, before Pesach, Passover is a time prepared for, very appropriate for redemption, for Elijah, as we know, the Laseda. No, but for this we need introduction to keep the Torah, the mitzvot, belief in God, which is very important. But Wir haben alle Kaiten, Jusser Effekt, was ist, ja, Desecrating Shabbos, and breaking very important laws of purity and so on. So, we are in difficult times. So, let us hope that this will do Tshuva, and this Pesach, Passover, even before we open, Messiah will come, bring peace and tranquility to Israel and to the whole world.